Hey, this is Frank. Welcome to another edition of MR2 Spyder for Dummies. This means you. Just kidding. We are looking in the engine bay of a 2005 Pontiac Vibe. This car has the 1.8 liter 1zz nearly exactly the same as the 1.8 liter 1zz in the MR2 Spyder. The reason we are looking at this is because I want to show you the location of an oil leak that would be impossible to find in an MR2 Spyder with the engine in the back. We found something very unexpected once we completed this repair. So keep watching. I've taken out the alternator. This in itself would be a big job in a Spyder, but it's trivial on this engine. I've taken out the alternator so we can look behind the alternator. So what's behind the alternator? First, we have the VVT solenoid. This is also known as the VVT oil control valve, or OCV. And this plugs into the harness and it inserts into the cylinder head. And it is just mounted with the 10 millimeter M6 bolt underneath. So I'm going to remove this solenoid. The alternator has to be out of the way in order to do that. And I'm going to show you the source of a potentially serious oil leak. So here's the solenoid. I've pulled it out of that round hole that's in the background there. And what you see on the solenoid is an O-ring. This O-ring seals in the oil that's circulating through the head at high pressure, and that activates the VVT, variable valve timing. And over the course of time, this O-ring right here, see it? It turns into the composition of ceramic. It becomes hard and brittle and no longer provides a seal for the oil. So I have pulled this OCV and I have replaced the O-ring already. And this is to correct a pretty substantial oil leak that was occurring on this engine. Now, how do I know that there was an oil leak? Well, before I cleaned off all of the oil, this area that you're viewing right now was completely covered in oil and it was not coming from the valve cover. So the O-ring that I used for replacement came out of this standard assortment of O-rings, and it was this one. And I wish I could tell you which one that is, but the label on the box has kind of become contaminated and illegible. This is a metric O-ring assortment, as you can see. So with the OCV O-ring addressed, we turn our attention to the next item, which is not so much a leak issue, but a maintenance issue. And this bolt right here with a 14 millimeter head is the holder for the OCV filter. Let's take it out and see what that looks like. So right here is the filter, and it just inserts into the tip of the bolt. It's wanting to come out right now. Okay, I just pushed it back in place. And it's not a bad practice to pull this filter out every once in a while, every 100,000 miles or so, or maybe more frequently, and just clean it off with brake clean. And this ensures proper oil flow through the head so that it does not get plugged up. If it does get plugged up, it'll lead to all kinds of noises and rattles in the VVT gear, and you might even get a VVT check engine light. Here's an update of something that I found almost unbelievable. After replacing the O-ring, drove the car, brought it back the next day, and what I found is you can see there's a little bit of oil right on the end of this oil control valve. So the oil is not leaking out of the O-ring that's inside the head. The oil, it's making its way back internally through the oil control valve and leaking out the back. And I've never seen this happen before. This means we need to replace this oil control valve, and that should take care of the oil leak. I thought you would want to see this because it's pretty interesting. Here's a maybe a little bit better view where you can see where the oil is coming out. That's all I wanted to cover in this video. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it.